In this video, I'll introduce the OneDrive integration in Canvas. And there is a lot going on here. So I've broken it into four parts, moving kind of from the simplest to the more complex, starting with OneDrive in the course navigation, then the OneDrive button in the rich content editor. We'll look at collaborations and then finally assignments. And you can use the chapters in the YouTube video to navigate or rewatch the sections that are most relevant to you. So let's get started with the simplest part of the integration. And that is that you can add OneDrive to the course navigation. Now, this doesn't really add anything in terms of, you know, your course design. It simply provides access to OneDrive from right here in Canvas. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to log into my course and I'm going to look for course settings in the navigation. And then I'm going to click navigation at the top. And here's where I can customize the course navigation for my students. So I'm just going to scroll down, look for the Microsoft OneDrive integration, and I'm going to drag it to the top section, put it wherever I want it to appear for my students. And then I'm going to scroll to the bottom and click save. So let's say you know you're going to be assigning a lot of papers for students to write. They're going to be using Word a lot. You might just want to give them this quick access to OneDrive, which they may not be used to using at UNCG at this time. This is just going to provide that quick access. And just to be extra clear, this is just giving each individual in the course access to their own OneDrive. It's not giving you access to your students' OneDrive, and it's not giving students access to your OneDrive. So let's take a look at it from the student perspective. And I do have two accounts in Canvas, so I can test things like this. You'll see here it's Audrey Louise Brickley. This is my admin account. And then I also am enrolled in this course as a student with my regular account, my just Audrey Brickley account. So let's go ahead and go to OneDrive in here, and you can see that this will give me, as a student in the course, access to my own OneDrive here. And I will be using these two accounts, my account where I'm a student in the course and my account where I'm a teacher in the same exact course, to give you both perspectives, because something like this, which is a third-party integration, Canvas Student View doesn't really work to give you that full experience. Okay, moving on to the OneDrive button in the rich content editor. And to demonstrate this, I'm going to add a syllabus to my course. So I'm going to go ahead and click edit. And here I get the rich content editor. And when we say rich content editor or RCE, this is what we're referring to. This is what you use anytime you're creating and editing content in Canvas, whether it's your syllabus or a page or an assignment, a discussion prompt, or a discussion reply even. This is the rich content editor, and there is now a OneDrive button in the rich content editor, which will allow you to share content with your students. So if you don't see the button right away, we're just going to expand until we find it. In this case, it is hiding behind this apps button. So if you ever know that you should see something, but you don't see it, look for this little plug, go ahead and click that, and then view all. You'll get a list of everything available, all the external apps available within the rich content editor. So you can see that OneDrive is one of the options. So I'm going to click that. And this is going to give me access to my OneDrive to add content. So I'm going to go ahead and go into the folder for this course. And I've already prepared the syllabus. And there's two options, embed or link. And I'm going to show you both so that you can see the difference. So let's start with the embed option. Okay, so it has embedded the file on the page. I'm going to go ahead and click update syllabus. If you're on a regular page or an assignment or something, you would see the option to save or save and publish. You'll probably notice a few things right away. The first one being that it does create quite a small area when you do use the embed option. Let's take a look at it from the student perspective. It does shrink that document down to fit in this area. So let's go ahead and do that over again, but use the link option. So fast forward into the future, I've updated this syllabus page so that it's linked instead of embedded. And so from the student perspective here, when I click that link, it does pop open a new tab in my browser where I can view a beautiful read-only copy of that document, and I have no ability to edit it. As the instructor, when I open that document, I am given this edit button here on the right, and it's very important to note that if you do have an update to this document that you want to reflect in your current course, you do need to access it this way. If you go back through your OneDrive and make an update to that original copy of your document, it is not going to reflect in your course. It's kind of created a new copy of this document specifically for this course for these students. So just remember, go back in through your course if you want to edit it. Don't go straight to your OneDrive because those changes will not be reflected and vice versa. So if I make a change to my syllabus here through Canvas, that original copy in my OneDrive is not going to reflect that change. Moving on to collaborations, I've already added this to the top part of my course navigation here, following that same process as I did earlier. And I'm going to go ahead and ignore Google Docs here and select Microsoft OneDrive from the dropdown. And this isn't necessarily more complex or more difficult than the last thing I showed you. It's just a little bit more complex in that we're involving more people. So this is a way to initiate a collaborative OneDrive document, meaning a Word document, a PowerPoint presentation, or an Excel spreadsheet from right here in Canvas that any or all of your students can collaborate in real time, work on together. So you can have an existing document ready to use here. For example, a lab worksheet that maybe your students are going to work on in groups. You want them to all collaborate on the same file. You can start that here. But for the sake of simplicity, for my example, I'm going to initiate a brand new blank document here. I'll just give it a name, and then I will simply decide who I want to collaborate on this Word document. And in this case, I'm going to go ahead and add my student Audrey and also Amanda to this document. Admin Audrey, that's me. I'm the teacher in this course. I don't need to add myself to have access to this document. I will automatically have access. I'll go ahead and click save. It does pop it open for me automatically in a new tab, and it allows me to edit the document. So this initial part here that it shows you is read-only. You do have to click this edit document option to start working on this document. So I'll just do something in this document. Now I'm going to hop over to the student view. I'm going to go ahead and click collaborations. And you'll see that I have access to this document right here from within the course. I'll click it, and it's going to do the exact same thing. Pop open this read-only version of the document that my instructor started. And then when I click edit document, here it is. And now I can start collaborating on this document as well. So pretty simple to set up and a very powerful collaboration tool with OneDrive right here in Canvas. And lastly, let's take a look at assignments. And there are two ways the OneDrive integration kind of affects assignments. The first is that it's simply an option for students now to upload submissions directly from their OneDrive. So whenever you select an online submission type and then file uploads, I'll show you what this looks like from the student perspective. So you're having them write a paper or do a PowerPoint or something like that when they are ready to complete that assignment. They have the more button here, and they'll be able to access their OneDrive directly instead of having to download, you know, the file from their OneDrive and then upload it to the assignment with that upload button. They will be able to simply upload the file this way. And the other way the OneDrive integration works with assignments is it actually allows you to use one of your own OneDrive files as a template that each student will get a copy of to complete and submit to this assignment. So we'll see how that works on their end in just a second. First, let's get this set up. So I'm going to scroll down to submission type, and instead of online, I'm going to select external tool. Then I'm going to click find, and I'm going to locate Microsoft OneDrive from this list, and I'll click that. And here's where I can access my own OneDrive files, and I can pick one of my files to use as that template. I'm going to click Attach. And then once it's uploaded, I will click Select. And then I'm actually going to uncheck Load This Tool in a New Tab this time, because I actually like the way it looks and the kind of visibility it gives students when we embed this on the page. So I'm going to click Save and Publish. And now I'm going to hop over and look at this from the student perspective. So here's that assignment. I'm my account where I'm a student in this course now, and I'm going to go ahead and complete this assignment. So when I click it, you'll see I get the instructions that my instructor wrote, followed by kind of this embedded template. So this is what I'm going to complete as a part of this assignment. I'm going to click Edit Document when I'm ready to get started, and it will kind of pop it open in M365 where I can now start working on it. I'll just add a few things and maybe something that's a little bit more visible so you can see what I'm saying. So what I can do now, I'm done working on this for today. I can simply close it, refresh my assignment. This is not submitted yet, but you'll see that having it embedded here on this page, it updates to wherever I left off, so I can go return to this another day if I don't get to finish it in one setting. Just go through that same process of returning to this assignment, clicking Edit Document to be able to access it and continue editing it. And then when I'm actually all done with this assignment, I will click Submit Assignment. And then I get that confirmation. And now let's hop back over to the instructor side and see what it looks like in SpeedGrader. So here it is. Here's that submission that Audrey, the student, completed and submitted via that OneDrive external tool assignment. And I can use all these awesome SpeedGrader features that I usually do. And there you have it, the OneDrive integration in Canvas. I hope this was helpful, and I can't wait to see all the unique and creative ways you will be using it with your students. As always, if you have questions or need support, feel free to reach out.